It's always a super fun night that celebrates amazing volunteers in our city. The VOscars are happening tomorrow night. With all the details right now, we say hello to Mary Eveline, who's with us, the Executive Director of Volunteer Ottawa. Nice to have you back on the couch here at Daytime Ottawa.
It's great to be back.
Tell us about this amazing organization, Volunteer Ottawa.
Well, we've been around for over 60 years, mm-hmm. and although we do a lot of services, most people just know us for our volunteer matching. So an individual who's looking for an opportunity in the city can register on our website and find an opportunity with an organization that they may feel passionate about.
Mm-hmm. We'll talk more about the matching process
right?
and all that
mm-hmm.
coming up, but we need to talk about the VOscars.
Yes.
Love that trendy name. Now, how many years? 9 years?
This is our 9th VOscars, yes.
Wow, congratulations. So what exactly takes place at a VOscars ceremony?
It's a really fun evening, but it's also an evening where we recognize individuals who've given back to our community.
Mm-hmm.
So we find that individuals give so much in the community in Ottawa, and once a year we try and say, okay, who are those individuals who've stood out, who've been nominated? This year we got 85 nominations for 6 awards.
Wow.
Which is really a demonstration of how committed people are in this city, so we recognize those volunteers.
Mm-hmm. We see pictures of, I believe this is last year's,
yes.
because I see
yep.
me in the corner there. So
that's right, you were hosting.
And it's just such a fun time, downtown City Hall, very classy night. So 6 awards. So what are the awards that are handed out?
Oh, we have a Lifetime Achievement Award. Of course, that's announced beforehand, and this year is Dennis Jackson. But we have a Mayor's Award. We have an award for seniors, youth,
mm-hmm.
Individuals who have given back to the community in terms of diversity.
Mm-hmm.
We have a Corporate Volunteering Award because we also have a program where we help businesses encourage their employees to volunteer, and we do group activities
mm-hmm.
for them. So we try and recognize those individuals in those categories. And so it's really one of the things we found is a lot of fun to sort of say there's a whole diverse range of volunteering opportunities,
hmm.
and by recognizing them in the different categories, we sort of demonstrate that.
Okay, can you tell us a bit more about Dennis Jackson? Because he seems like
he's
getting a pretty big award here.
He is, yes, and he's been volunteering for over 30 years. He's worked both nationally and locally. He has been working with United Way, both nationally and locally, and he just is an individual who is so committed to Ottawa
mm-hmm.
that we felt we really had to recognize. And we try every year to pick someone who's just exemplifies what a volunteer means, and Dennis Jackson's is one we picked this year.
It's got to be difficult to pick just one person every
year,
though.
Oh, it's incredibly difficult.
From this amazing
Even
city.
With the other 6 awards, because we had so many nominations, we
yeah.
only picked 3 individuals who can be finalists, and the award is anonymous, so they don't know yet.
Mm.
So they're going to go to the event tomorrow night, and we do it like a VOscars,
oh,
right?
Nice.
The envelope, please, and their family and friends are there, and
yeah.
they help celebrate what they've done.
That's super. Okay, so how do you help recruit volunteers to get out into our community?
You can do it a number of different ways. Organizations will post opportunities on our website, but also you can just go register on our website. And right now we have a pool of almost 10,000 volunteers
My gosh.
Who want to give back to our community. And I have a really interesting statistics for you.
Yeah.
Do you know that in Ottawa, 55 million hours annually are given to volunteering?
I don't believe it.
I do, because I know what Ottawa is like.
But I mean 55
million? 55
million
hours
incredible.
Annually. And that.
Wow.
So it just gives you a good indication of the range of opportunities that are available for volunteers,
mm-hmm.
whether you want to help children, whether you want to do music programs or coach a sporting activity. One of the key things that volunteers helped with was after the tornado this year.
Mm-hmm.
The city couldn't handle all the people who wanted to volunteer. I mean,
mm-hmm.
it's a really difficult process to make sure everyone's been screened and then trained adequately in order to be a volunteer. So it's really what I always say to individuals is find something you're passionate about
mm-hmm.
and then look for an opportunity. And
okay.
we have, on any given day, there's 500 on our website.
Okay, and it doesn't matter age? I mean,
no, a lot of high school students, for example, have to get their 40 hours.
Yeah.
So they come to our website and look for opportunities. And that some opportunities aren't available to youth because of dealing with vulnerable populations and that. But we encourage everyone, you're never too young to start volunteering. And we have a lot of families that volunteer together.
Mm-hmm.
And that, and I think once you get the bug, you'll continue volunteering
mm-hmm.
for your whole life.
And spring and summer, definitely a busy time for volunteers because people are sort of, they want to get out.
They want to get out, and there's a lot of, clean up the city. There's a lot of parks that have to be cleaned up, a lot of areas that, over the winter have had problems with flooding or snow damage and that, and they need help to ensure that the grounds are safe and can be used again.
Mm-hmm.
So we find the spring and summer is probably our busiest time
mm-hmm.
in that, and that's when we have a lot of corporations who get all their employees out
mm-hmm.
volunteering. For example, every spring we have a company that has 1,000 individuals who come and volunteer.
Okay. Some of the benefits of volunteering?
I think that it allows you to sort of try out things that you might be interested in. For example, if you're looking for, as a youth, looking for a career, mm-hmm. You might be interested in an area and you go and volunteer and say, gee, that's for me, or no, it's not for me.
Yeah.
And that, so it could be a stepping stone mm-hmm. to a lifetime career.
Builds your resume.
It's absolutely. And mm-hmm. for new Canadians, it's an opportunity to get to know our culture mm-hmm. and try out different things.
Okay, 30 seconds left here. It's sold out tomorrow night.
Yes, it
for the
is.
VOscars, yep. But if people want to start thinking about perhaps nominating somebody for next year's mm-hmm. VOscars, when should they?
They should probably start thinking about in the fall. We yeah. usually put up the application process in December because we find that, excuse me, we have so many individuals being nominated that it takes us a long time to process the nominations okay. and try and choose three individuals in each category out of 87 volunteer nominations. It's really difficult.
Marie, thank you very much. VolunteerOttawa.ca.
Thank you very much.
More daytime coming up on Rogers TV.